setup. Super Frogs with the hyper aggressive Shaman play might be able to run them over, but I think XRB to the moon shows a good comp.
Indeed, they won with this composition last time in the spring finals, and they went to around 60% dampening, so everyone needs to get on their dampening seatbelts for this one, I believe. They're going on to Warwix right now, trying to slay him. We're going to expect a long game. Blizzard and Warwix and Looney are just incredibly good with their defense player. Kidney shot onto Looney right now. Warwix teleports away instantly. That is the Vendetta. An Infernal Stun onto Wealthy Man right now. It looks like he might use the gateway. Actually, he gets Ironbarked right now, and it looks like he should be able to survive this ordeal.
Yeah, Warwick's going to be taking a little bit of damage. Like you said, this could be a long game, so get ready. Blizzo's going to be trying to connect the channels. Look, it's a game of cat and mouse, and Chanimal so far is winning that war, easily cutting Blizzo. Blizzo having to turn his attention over on the Cubsy, but Cubsy with a nice root, going to be able to run away as well. In the meantime, Wealthy Man creating good pressure onto Walrein.
Indeed, and Blizzard's just looking to try and chase Chanimal's right now. I do feel his pain. He lands a charge on him. Chanimal's could teleport if needed. He's just going to keep trying to kite Blizzo constantly. He's in battle stance, trying to pump the pressure onto him. Looney spamming those roots, might be playing with that root talent so it doesn't break, and that could be very interesting, giving Blizzard a lot more uptime onto Chanimals. And whilst that is happening, Wealthy Man's onto Warwick. He kidneys him, getting quite a lot of pressure. He's gonna have that Vendetta soon, but it looks like he's okay. He actually lands a spell lock onto Looney right now. Warwick's gate teleports away. Looks like he's gonna set up another gateway.
Yeah, Blizzard trying to reconnect. Once again, Chanimals doing a good job kiting. Nice root coming in from Cubsy. And that's what it is. These two melee, Blizzo and Wealthy Man, they just need to create as much pressure as possible, taxing the other healer's mana. Just the Warlocks need to get those dots, and it really does take a long time just because of how mobile those Affliction Warlocks really are.
Indeed, and Looney actually forced Wealthy Man, he put a root onto him as well, and these roots are just forcing them to create more distance and to give Warwick more kiting opportunities. Although Looney now is actually falling behind on mana, but we know that he loves to get those mid-game drinks. He knows he's definitely going to be expecting that mana game, so it'll be interesting to see if Super Frogs could stop him drinking. They're actually getting Blizzard a bit low right now. He's forced into the defensive stance at the same time. Wealthy Man getting crushed. He kidneys Blizzard. He might be out of line of sight a bit. It looks like no Vendetta gets used though right now. He is playing that awkward lens, so that kidney isn't going to last too long. Wealthy Man's in trouble right now. He just survives that XQ range with the evasion. Spelllock on the Cubsy as well, and they already forced a major defensive cooldown.
Yeah, as soon as these melee get close to each other, that's when the action happens. Bashed on the Cubsy. Is Looney going to be able to get the clone? No, Chanimals will be able to deny it. Another kidney shot on Blizzo, though. Cubsy doesn't look like he's going to be throwing out the purges, but this is good pressure from Super Frogs. Looney and Blizzo kind of falling behind. Cheap drop now on Looney. Out of form, no trinket. There's the Vendetta. A lot of pressure coming in. Bear form should be enough to deflect, though. Walrein's there going to be able to throw out some fears, too, if he needs to. But this is good for Super Frogs.
Indeed. He uses that Barkskin as well as that artifact to just stabilize and deal with this Vendetta pressure right now. And right now they're going to be fine with that, but deep into dampening, it could be a lot harder. And kidney damage onto Blizzo right now. He uses that Warbreaker. He's trying to connect onto Chanimals once again. And he's just, both of these Warlocks are kiting to perfection right now. Cubsy using that healing tide, they've fallen behind a bit on healing. Blizzo is just about connecting right now, has a lot of uptime right now, but Wealthy Man is near everyone. The entire team is just so clumped up that they need to be careful of that kidney shot.
It's actually funny, with them all clumped up, there's a lot of pressure for both teams. Walrein's looking for some UAs, Chanimals lands a spell lock. Blizzo reconnects to Chanimals. Wealthy Man now on Walrein. Looney, actually, I think he gated away, so he's taking more of a defensive position, maybe realizing they weren't getting the better end of that exchange. Looney a little bit behind on mana as well. Still not in dampening, but big pressure for both teams.
Indeed, and when every time Blizzo has pushed in onto Chanimals, by the time he's finally allowed to connect, Chanimals is just crushing him with the dot pressure, forcing him into defensive stance, and that's what's keeping him alive right now. But Looney's been going for a drink, and these are the drinks, the game-winning drinks that XRB to the moon need, but they're unable to get it because Cubsy doing an excellent job of leaping in, stopping that drink, and they're all tired on mana. Looney gets blinded, he trinkets out of it. Warwick's in a lot of trouble right now. Wealthy Man holding on to that Vendetta. He knows he needs to try and force the Iron Bark or the wall coming out from Warwick for him to pop that cooldown.
Yeah, Walrein seems to be focusing down the pet of Chanimals. You can see the health funnels coming in. He needs to keep that pet alive. It can be very annoying once that pet goes down, like we sort of talked about. Kidney shot now on Walrein. He responds with the Unending Resolve, but they have so much damage. He gates away. That was the Unending Resolve. It's a very long cooldown, so that's a very big victory there for Super Frogs with that Vendetta. While we're still not out of the woods yet, still rotting down low. Ironbark going to be overlapped there for XRB to the moon. They're not going to have some defenses for quite some time.
Indeed, they did survive the Vendetta go there, and both Warlocks trading out their walls at exactly the same time. Both getting very low. Chanimals nearly into that execute range, and Warwick's nearly dropping down to Wealthy Man's pressure with that Vendetta, and they could look for opportunities before that Ironbark comes back.
Yep, all four members sort of stacked up once again. Healer's taking a defensive position. Looney doesn't want to get dotted up, doesn't want to be in range of those Shadow Step kidney shots that Wealthy Man has. He's very intelligent. Cubsy does get interrupted, so some pressure here mounting for XRB as Chanimals gets lower. No on any resolve for him as well. Blizzo trying to take advantage of that Fel stun, but unfortunately Chanimals is able to pour it away, looking for a Fel Hunter summon once again. I think he actually faked the pummel. No! Blizzo still has the pummel, so Chanimals now having to get that pet out. Does he have a Storm Bolt? No. It's going to be safe once again and be able to get those dots rolling to get some pressure for his team.
Indeed, Looney once again trying to get that Vortex onto the teleports, and now he's going for a drink. Cubsy does dispel. He is a bit low on mana, but Warwick gets put into that kidney shot. He needs to be careful. Looney comes out knowing he needs to keep him alive. He did get that slight drink, though. Full fear onto him as well. They need to be careful. Warwick might need to gate away. There's the gate. The Vendetta gets popped. He needs to Iron Bark him, and there it is. The Iron Bark going to stabilize him. Blizzard a bit low as well. He needs to pump out the heals to keep them alive right now, and then they can probably take this into deep dampening. He gets stepped into a kick, though. Blizzard really far away from Looney right now. It needs to be a bit careful. Warwick summoning out his pet. Chanimals getting dropped down low at the same time. Cubsy does have the defensive corners, but he's getting dropped into near execute range. He might just go down. I believe that was maybe the Hellstone coming out of it, or Cubsy just doing an excellent job keeping him alive.
Yeah, Looney trinkets out of the blind, so standard for that. Blizzo still rotting down low, though. Looney actually taking a more offensive position, moving in, looking for the bash out of that interrupt onto Cubsy. Cubsy leaps away. Doesn't look like it's going to be any follow-up CC. Walrus now caught into the full kidney shot from Wealthy Man. Super Frogs looking to find some damage, but Looney constantly getting the drinks in this game has put him ahead on mana, and that's looking good as we are at 10% dampening.
Oh, Wealthy Man actually cloaked because of these deep root entangling roots coming out from Looney, and there could be an opportunity on Wealthy Man. He still has that trinket evasion safety net to survive those executes, and right now Warwick is actually the one dropping low. Vendetta coming up very soon. A cross kick onto Looney right now. Warwick's dropping lower and lower, trying to pump out the
General
afflictions. The Spirit Link comes out from Cubsy as well as the Healing Tide. Blizzo crushing Chanimals. At the same time, Warwick is soloing Wealthy Man. This is a dire situation for Super Frogs.
Cubsy does have the Ascendance. He needs to get out those casted heals, but they're trying to deny. Nice bash from Looney. Wealthy Man staying on top of Cubsy. Cubsy finally able to get off those casts. Now a kidney shot on Blizzo. This is looking really good for XRB to the Moon. Looney has a massive mana advantage. Cubsy really doesn't have any defensive healing abilities left, so if they can once again get that kind of pressure, it's going to be very difficult for Cubsy to deal with it.
Indeed, and right now dampening is ticking in 15%. Cubsy getting low on mana and low on cooldowns as well. Spelllock onto Chanimals, they're trying to survive themselves. Spelllock onto Cubsy. Warwick's just owning them with these spelllocks right now, forcing the demonic resolve from Chanimals. Blizzard did pop that battle cry. He's trying to pressure Chanimals like crazy. He's getting his own unstable afflictions out onto Warwick's though right now, and they're trying to force the Ironbark. Looney dispels the unstable afflictions. Warwick's is kiting as well, but he gets caught. Step kidney onto Warwick's. Vendetta being popped in there. Once again, Looney answers with the Iron Buck, but he needs to be able to get the heals out. He gets Spelllock. This could be a very difficult situation for Warwick to survive. At the same time, Wealthy Man dropping low. He has his corners to survive. Chanimals dropping very low. No Spear Ring like now. Warwick's getting so low. Had to use his own wall as well as that Hellstone. Both teams are getting rotted down. Chanimals incredibly low. He's just about kiting. Blizzard reconnects that huge gateway, but Blizzard reconnects. He has the execute range. He pops the battle cry. Back onto Cubsy. I think he should be able to take this, but a blind onto Blizzo is what's keeping them alive right now. But if that ends, he might be able to take him out. All teams very low once again. The half fear breaks onto Cubsy. Pummel onto Chanimals. Execute range. He gets finished. He finally gets the execute off. The defensive blind was nearly enough for them to survive. But XRB to the Moon take game number one.
That is a big victory, too, to start things off here in this series. What a weird game, though, to really see compared to the other stuff that we have seen in this tournament. It is just a battle of rotting down. We get to around what I believe is like 15% into dampening, and you can just see at any moment, anyone could just fall down to that rot pressure that is coming out from both sides, Eco.
Yeah, and I mean, if both the melees can get to stick onto their targets, if the warrior and the warlock get to stick to their targets, then the warrior typically in dampening tends to outvalue that assassination rogue. Now, the problem is usually the warrior doesn't get to stick to his target that often. Blizzo, though, doing a fantastic job managing to stick onto Chanimals, playing that double time talent actually in that last game, realizing that the Storm Bolt is not going to be super key for their victory, but instead having as much recharge as well behind that pillar and then connect there towards the ending moments of the game. And Blizzo, he did such a phenomenal job just putting up the pressure. Warix as well, managing.
Though they do have that first win in the bag, but will Super Frogs be able to use this small map to get tied in this series?
All right, we're gonna see which team can dampen better XRB to the moon. That's Super Frogs getting in right away. And we are on that small map, so both melees may be able to find openings earlier. Blizzard gets put into that sap. Garrokh cheap shot onto Looney. He does pre-bear it once again. Looney's gonna always be ready to pre-bear those potential goes from the rogue. Kidney shot onto Blizzard right now. He's playing that relentless orc as well, so that's gonna be heavily reduced. Bash on the Warwick, spell lock on the Chanimals. Things are just stabling right now.
Yeah, Looney gonna be popping that innervate, looking to get out huge heals very early on. Doesn't want his team to fall behind. Looks like Wealthy Man wants to just spread his dots everywhere. Super Frog's gonna be looking for a triple pressure here, maybe knocking off the Vim from Looney if he is playing that talent. But so far, Looney's in a good position. He is in a full kidney shot right now. No trinket gonna be available. Vendetta has been popped. I think Looney should be okay with the bark skin, but good pressure from Super Frogs.
Indeed, Warwick's actually timing his Infernal Stun as well onto Wealthy Man, buying Looney time to get into that Bear Form, survive with just the bark skin. They're looking good for now to survive that early first Vendetta. Wealthy Man onto Warwick right now. It looks like both melee are just on each other's Warlocks, and it will come down to who's able to stabilize on that mana better. Full kidney shot onto Blizzard whilst he's connected. Looney used that War Stomp onto Chanimals there, trying to fake out these spell locks, but both of these Warlocks are just so incredible using that spell lock.
Yeah, Chanimals trying to load up Looney with dots once again. You can tell Wealthy Man, he wants to land those stuns, wants to get that pressure, but making sure he dots up Blizzo as well as Walrox, just keeping the pressure where he can. Full kidney shot now secured onto Walrox. In the meantime, though, Blizzo just ripping into Chanimals. He gets lower and lower. Thorn's going to be used there by Cubsy to keep him alive. No Ironbark available. Chanimals looking like he's going to be okay. Big heals from Cubsy with that artifact ability.
Indeed, I love that play from Looney and Blizzard. When he pops that battle cry, Looney uses that Ursa Vortex to get a lot of pressure. Looks like Cubsy's trying to do the same onto Walrox. Maybe try and Vortex each other's portals, which could give them a huge swing of momentum and pressure on the Warlocks. But both of them are doing an excellent job not to fall for that bait right now. Blizzard getting pressured down. He looks to connect on the Chanimals. A beautiful bash from Looney is going to allow him to reconnect right now. Spell lock on the Cubsy as well. They're trying to get pressure, but at the same time, Blizzard is the one that's dropping low. The Vendetta gets used as well. Looney still has that Iron Bark, but isn't even. It does actually use it in the end. Warwick does get put into that kidney shot. That's going to get that Iron Bark, and they're going to stabilize for now.
Yeah, Cubsy a little bit ahead on mana right now, and that could definitely be a factor as this game moves forward. Blizzard all over Chanimals, but Cubsy in a good spot to toss those toss up. Looney in mid map as well. Nice roots onto Wealthy Man. You can see Wealthy Man, he's just stuck in those roots like Joe has been talking about. The Deep Roots is such an effective talent against that Assassination Rogue. Full blind on Looney. Is he going to trinket? Wealthy Man looking for the damage on Walrox, but really not able to connect. Looney's going to be able to comfortably sit through that blind. No fear of a follow-up sap or anything like that. So a little bit of a waste there for Super Frogs.
Indeed, and Blizzard actually kited back to the pillar during that blind. That was actually such a smart decision. If he followed Chanimals and fell for that bait, he could have went down and would have had to use his defensive cooldowns, and I think that's what saved him, kind of, you know, flashbacks from the spring finals right there. But he is pressuring Chanimals, trying to keep up to him right now. Chanimals uses his trinket. Blizzard pops that battle cry. Spell lock though onto Looney. Blizzard's gonna be in trouble. No Iron Bark can be used right now. A lot of pressure mounting up onto Blizzard. The cheap shot onto Blizzard, kidney shot onto Looney as well. They're trying to finish him off. He's dropping lower and lower. The rallying cry comes out. Still no die, but it's sort of full fear lands. It does break though, and Looney's using that artifact to try and heal him. He dispels the UAs, but Super Frogs have a lot of momentum right now.
Yeah, Walrox gets interrupted. Chanimals are really trying to shut down this damage as they have all the pressure on their side. Walrox getting lower and lower. Looney's going to activate that artifact, just toss out those regrowths. A lot of effective healing now, able to stabilize his team. Walrox should be fine, still has the Hellstone, still has the Unending Resolve. And now Blizzard's looking to get aggressive, tearing into Wealthy Man just a little bit, as well as Chanimals as they rot down lower and lower. And you can see Cubsy's actually way behind on mana at this point. There has been like a momentum shift in terms of the mana bar.
Indeed, and Blizzard is so perfect with those battle and defensive stance switches. He literally just went into defensive stance before the cheap shot. He feared the gateway once again from Chanimals. He is absurdly good at doing that, but now he's getting crushed. The Vendetta comes out, being answered by the Ironbark. Looney spamming out those heals. Meanwhile, Blizzard pops the battle cry as well, trying to get his own counter pressure onto both Wealthy Man and Chanimals. Wealthy Man having to use that Cloak of Shadows as well. This could buy an opportunity for Warwick to mount that pressure.
Yeah, Cubsy gets interrupted. Nicely done by Walrox. He's going to fall further and further behind. He does have the Ironbark available. Wealthy Man really doesn't have too many defensives. No Cloak of Shadows, just the evasion. Needs to be very careful, but he he's just stuck in the roots once again. You can see Looney throwing out solar wraths on him, just wrathing him down, getting him lower and lower. Chanimals on top of Looney now going to be loading him up with dots. I really feel like Super Frogs, they need to be looking to those swaps on the Looney. That seems to be the advantage the Rogue has. But Walrus going to be put into the Kidney Shot. Big burst coming in from Wealthy Man. No Vendetta available. That is the King's Bane. But I think Looney's going to be able to heal through it.
Indeed, he just keeps answering that Vendetta with the Iron Bark, and soon Blizzo has his Battle Cry. No Iron Bark from Clumsy. They could make a potential kill onto Chanimals. He's just used his teleport now as well. If they can reconnect and use the Vortex, there's the Bash. Blizzo wants to get offensive. He's trying to pressure him down so much, but Chanimals once again kiting, and Clumsy using his own roots onto Blizzo. A Kidney Shot onto Blizzo is now. He's in Battle Stance as well. He gets caught out once. Looney not needing to use the Iron Bark dispels that unstable afflictions. He's in that defensive stance now, and he should be okay just now when dampening kicks in.
Ooh, Looney going for a drink. If he gets a lot of mana here, this is very dangerous. Cubsy also, he can't go for a drink. Looney's gonna be full mana at this point. This is horrible for Super Frogs. Bash over on the Looney. Super Frogs need to win here, but the nice parry coming in from Blizzo on that Kidney Shot. Looney at around 60% mana. That was a huge victory for XRB to the moon if they can manage to stabilize, but Blizzo could go down here. Looney definitely doesn't want to be greedy with that Iron Bark. He's gonna be throwing it out onto Walrick to keep him alive, save that unending resolve as we move deeper and deeper into dampening.
Indeed, he pre-died by the sword on the Kidney Shot. That was such an excellent play. A defensive blind now comes. They want Cubsy to try and drink and get mana, but Warwick has his pair on him, so he's unable to. They're trying to buy time. Warwick's dropping lower and lower. He dispels the unstable afflictions, puts that thorns up, and is kind of backfiring with these thorns. It's just gonna kind of rot each other's melee down. Chanimals dropping low. Cubsy completely out of mana, and that small drink from Looney might be the victory right now. Iron Bark onto Chanimals, he's getting super low. Blizzo connecting, full bash on the Chanimals. He could die through the Demonic Resolve as well. This is a dire situation from Super Frogs. The Seduce on the Cubsy as well. He sits it, but Chanimals uses that Hellstone.
He uses every single defensive he has. Cubsy's still caught in the fear. They're not out of it just yet. 10% dampening. It's going to be difficult for Cubsy with no mana available. Vendetta almost available for Wealthy Man. Is there any openings? Looney has his trinket. Blizzo really doesn't have too much. Kidney Shot over onto him. Could they take him down? Whoa. Kingsbane onto Blizzo. Bash onto Looney. Blizzo could be in some trouble, but Looney's able to dispel the UAs. Still has that Iron Bark, and Cubsy's still just running on fumes. I don't think he can last much longer, Joe.
Indeed, and there's the Iron Bark on that Vendetta for Blizzard. With that defensive stance, he should be enough to survive for now. He's just going to gun down for Chanimals. He really wants to take him down before that Iron Bark comes down. He doesn't have the wall. Dampening keeps ticking lower and lower. It's going to be incredibly hard. I don't know how Super Frogs are going to survive at this point. Blizzard goes into battle stance. He's sensing blood in the waters. He wants to get into that execute range. Iron Bark comes out now on the Chanimals, but all of Super Frogs are incredibly low. Wealthy Man has to use that evasion in the crossfire. He step kicks Warwick to try and reduce the pressure, but at the end of the day, I'm not sure how they're going to survive. Vortex trying to get bait that poor Chanimals reads it like a book. They're able to teleport afterwards. They're trying to pressure Blizzard right now, force him into that defensive stance, but he reconnects onto Chanimals, and he's allowed to just keep going on in him again and again.
Cubsy had such a sick innervate there. He was able to fully hot up his team. In the meantime, Blizzard getting really low. Nothing available for him. No Iron Bark available. Looney dispels the dots, but still, he's not out of it yet. Wealthy Man wants to close out this game. Cubsy getting interrupted. Everyone is dying. Blizzard gets lower and lower, but he wants to close out this game. Wealthy Man and Chanimals need to avoid some damage. Another fear on the Chanimals. He pours away. He needs to run away from Blizzo. Full blind coming in from Wealthy Man just to keep his team alive a little bit longer in this situation. Cubsy completely tapped on mana. Blizzo moving in for the execute. Is he going to be able to get it? Fair form comes in from
charge.
He just leaps away. He gets charged to execute.
Oh.
And eventually, XRB to the Moon will claim game number two.
And now XRB to the Moon is just one game away from completely snuffing out the dreams of NA, and guaranteeing that five teams from EU will go to BlizzCon, something that we have never seen before. That is something that comes from the new format this year, and XRB to the Moon appears to be on absolute fire. Before we got into this series, we said, is there any chance that maybe these guys are on tilt? Both these teams come to this exact series in two very different ways. You know, Super Frogs is in on a bit of a heater after they had their loss a little bit earlier in the tournament, and XRB, they just dropped down here today, and now, Joe, it's kind of looking like the case is XRB is feeling good.
Indeed. I mean, that first game was really close, but now I think they made the mistake of trying to out-dampen XRB to the Moon. I just don't think any team is going to be doing that. Super Frogs are very close contenders, though, but maybe they don't have enough experience as the Rogue Lock Druid. I mean, that one drink from Looney is probably the only reason they pulled ahead as well. And those small differences are what's going to matter in these long dampening games.
Now, I doubt what has been happening in this tournament to make them come back to that form.
They've stopped picking Locke, Druid, and Elite Shaman every single game. Fine.
Not only themselves, but the entire region. This game can decide that five teams from EU will go to BlizzCon. If XRB wins this, it will snuff out the hope of NA.
Yeah, Blizzo's gonna be moving in. He sees his target, it's Chanimals. He wants to connect and rip in once again, but Chun-Li's gonna be denying it. You can see Chun-Li, for the first time I think ever, is actually gonna be playing an Orc Windwalker Monk instead of that patented Blood Elf using the Ride the Wind to help Chanimals get away.
Indeed, Blizzard using that Blazon with the Battlecry straight away, trying to mount some pressure onto Chanimals. The double charge has been used. He teleports away. I wouldn't be surprised to see a gateway very soon from Chanimals to kite Blizzard and be able to avoid some damage. Looks like the Urban Shield Tome is going to be used instead from Cubsy. Looks like he's going to just try and make a swap onto Blizzard, but he actually pre-defensive stance to go reading that play, but he's still dropping very, very low. Looney has to dispel those unstable afflictions right now. The Radiant Cry comes out as well. They're able to put so much pressure even on the defensive stance warrior from 100%.
Here's the nice thing about the Windwalker Monk. He can put his port on Chanimals when Blizzo gets a little bit aggressive. If he's fully loaded up with dots, Chun-Li can just port back, get him into his stun, and really punish that aggression. That might be something that really is impactful later on in the game.
Indeed, and Looney tried to vortex that gateway. That was so, so close. That would have been such a cut fade. Chun-Li giving a big Ride the Wind right now as well. A DR sap onto Looney is not going to do too much. Chun-Li now trying to create some pressure on the Warwick. He gets cloned. Looney actually playing with the clone now instead of that Deep Roots. And I think that's a smart decision by Looney because Chun-Li could use that Tiger's Lust to break those roots.
Yeah, Chun-Li's still going to be putting a little bit of pressure on the Walrex. Unfortunately for him, Walrex was able to resummon his pet. I think that's going to be a theme of this game as well. Chanimals really wants to kill off that pet, but a nice swap over on Looney with the Fist of Fury. Chun-Li putting out huge damage. Leg sweep on the bear form, basically soloing Looney down. Very nicely done, and that is the burst we see from Chun-Li, which is absolutely insane.
He is such a monster on this Windwalker, just making swap potentials where you don't even expect them and nearly taking them out. And that's what Super Frogs need if they want to win this game. Blizzard getting lower and lower as well. Chun-Li making a swap on the Blizzard. He is in that defensive stance. It looks like he should be okay for now. Sap on the Looney there. It was half, so he's going to be able to get into that bear form. Chun-Li dropping lower and lower as well. Gets put into that bash. Blizzard's going to connect with the Battlecry battle stance as well. Chun-Li needs to be careful right now. The Vortex comes out as well. Chun-Li using that Rider Wind to get away and to connect onto Warwick.
Yeah, a little bit of pressure coming in. Double Fist of Fury stun, but this is the thing about the Windwalker Monk. They don't have the same kind of consistent pressure we see from an Assassination Rogue. To get that Rot pressure is going to take a little bit more dampening, but what we do see from Chun-Li is a little bit more burst potential. We've seen him almost take Blizzo down, almost take Looney down, so XRB to the Moon needs to be very careful of that. It's going to be difficult. Even a Windwalker Monk as good as Chun-Li can be very hard to land those kills.
Indeed, and Super Frogs still need to find their kills, I believe. Otherwise, it's going to be the same situation where XRB to the Moon can now dab it, but Looney gets caught out into a snap. He pops that basket immediately. This is such a huge go from Chun-Li. He gets feared on his touch of death, but it breaks immediately. But it's going to buy enough time for Looney to get into that bear form. He bashes up Cubsy. They're trying to counter pressure Chun-Li as well. Blizzard connecting onto Cubsy now. He gateways away. I like that Chanimals keeps repositioning those gateways, and what a beautiful crack, Jade Crackling Lightning from Chun-Li to just add to the kiting against Blizzo.
Yeah, Blizzo not having a very good time trying to connect to his target. Chun-Li is going to be going on to Walrex once again, and that was a nice setup coming in from Chun-Li and Cubsy. Put the incapacitate onto Looney, and then it was a cap stun, cap totem coming in from Cubsy out of that, so didn't really need the leg sweep. If they can consistently do that, they might find these opportunities onto Looney fairly consistently. Cubsy looking for a drink. Looney was able to shut it down, but Cubsy's doing fine on mana. Looney's obviously going to be doing fine on mana as well. I think, Joe, this game is going to go on for quite a while.
It is indeed, and those little mana drinks could give them those advantages. Like I said, in these dampening gameplays, there's not much to do apart from improving those very small defensive gameplays that could be the deciding match into winning this. And Super Frogs need that right now. If they lose this game, they will be out of the competition. So they need to be very careful. That bash onto Chanimals right there. He trinkets out of it, trying to get away from Blizzard. Blizzard is connected though. A spell lock onto Cubsy. They could mount the pressure. Chun-Li actually gets a Fist of Fury, but Blizzard pre-blade storms it, denying the stun from Chun-Li. What a great play. But he teleports and catches Looney off guard with the leg sweep. He doesn't have the Fist of Fury to follow up. Warwick is spamming out those fears to disrupt the gameplay. XRB to the Moon are looking very good.
Yeah, Looney didn't overreact to the situation. Still has his bar skin. Knowing Chun-Li, he didn't have the Fist Blast of Fury didn't really have too much damage, so that was nicely done. XRB to the moon, they're playing well defensively. Like you said, Blizzard with that Blade Storm on the Fist of Fury, really denying the opportunities of Super Frogs. And you can see XRB to the moon putting out a lot of pressure to Super Frogs. Nice little swap going out onto Blizzard. He's in D stance, should be completely fine. Chun-Li's just basically bouncing all over the place, just trying to create little opportunities for his team throughout the game.
Indeed, it's such a pleasure to see all six of these players on their main cast playing it so incredibly well. But Chanmas is dropping down really low right now to Blizzo's pressure. He gets stunned, he pre-defensive stances the stun though. Chanmas gets an unstable affliction, he needs to be careful. Looney pops that Iron Bark right now. A Spellock onto Cubsy as well, both teams starting to get pressure into this dampening. Blizzard connecting, Chanmas uses that teleport, wants to get away from Blizzo as much as possible, but that Vortex might allow him to reconnect. A beautiful bash coming out from Looney as well. What a great play by Looney. That's going to force out the wall from Chanimals, and once again, look at Dire. Another pre-defensive stance from Blizzo on that Fist of Fury. They are on fire right now.
That was a nice setup from Chun-Li. Incapacitate onto Looney, Fist on Blizzo, and Chanimals actually able to get the fear out of that. That's where this pressure is coming from, but they just hit Blizzo, get him low, and then run away from him. They say, forget it, we're not going to take him down through D-stance. We're just trying to create as much pressure as possible, really limiting the uptime of the Warrior, and that is their main advantage. If they can kite Blizzo throughout this game, especially as it gets longer, it's going to be really difficult. You can see Blizzo, I've seen him mount up a few times in this matchup. He's just having such a hard time connecting to Chanimals.
Indeed, he actually finds a mount up and might be able to connect. Chun-Li looking to slow him down, rolls to make sure that that happens, and it's going to be very hard for him to connect to Chanimals. He's just connecting on whatever target he can, trying to get as much pressure as possible. But at the
Look
same
at
time, Chun-Li just onto Warwick's as well right now. Blizzard getting kited in their battle stance, and he's trying to just keep mounting up and get it to connect.
Bash on the Looney. Blizzo literally hasn't hit anyone in 30 seconds here, so this is the effectiveness of this composition. Blizzo finally reconnecting, but he gets stunned. Can he get the snare onto Chanimals before he ports away? He's able to get a little bit of pressure coming in now as well. That battle cry going to be used by Blizzo to try to get some momentum. Chun-Li actually has no trinket. He still has the karma, but Chanimals able to get away a little bit, but Blizzo's on top of him. Nice off pummel by Cubsy, but Chanimals gates away, looking for the Fellhunter stun, is able to get, or Fellhunter resummon, is able to get that up. And now Blizzo once again having a difficult time reconnecting Chanimals, turning his attention onto Cubsy. And I like this adaptation here, just trying to spread that worry damage all over the place.
Indeed, a beautiful spot from Looney, but he pre-bears the legs. We've Spellock onto Cubsy, and it looks like they're getting rotted down. Even though they're kiting Blizzard the entire game, Warwick is able to mount so much pressure right now. Looney getting the tranquility of going to top his team right now. Chun-Li does have that Storm Murph and Fire Sweep. Blizzard is finally connecting onto Chanimals, getting a lot of pressure. He uses that Reflect though for Warwick just to make sure he denies some dots. A full bash on a Cubsy into a Cyclone. This could be devastating. Blizzard's connecting on the channel. He's getting a lot of pressure with that Battle Cry right now. The Urban Shield Totem comes up from Cubsy. He's looking to heal. He gets cross pummeled by Blizzard. Channel's dripping lower and lower. It's going to be harder for him to top, but a beautiful Ride the Wind coming out from Chun-Li.
Yeah, that's going to allow Chanimals to escape, and they just consistently kill off Chanimals' pet in this matchup, always having to port away. Another nice swap going out onto Blizzo, but Looney in a good position to just throw out heals. Cubsy's mana's not doing bad, though. XRBs, they have crazy pressure, but Cubsy's still hanging in there, around 50% mana. Blizzo once again trying to reconnect to his target. Chun-Li actually rotting down. He has the touch of karma. He's actually looking for Looney, but Looney did a good job. He's hiding. Fortunately, that spinning crane kick's not able to get him out of stealth, and he gets a huge drink because of it.
Indeed, a huge drink and forcing the touch of karma. That's very good for XRP to the moon, and I love what Chun-Li did earlier. He's using the Tiger's Lust on a Charge Rune. That's such a high level play, and it just denies Blizzard to be able to connect him at all, not even being able to get a Hamstring or a Ren. It's just going to die him so much pressure, and plays like that might help Super Frogs to be able to win this match. Looney pushes him with a bash now onto Chanimals. He trinkets out of it. He does not want Blizzard to connect on him right now, but he's connecting onto Cubsy. The Spellock lands onto him. Chun-Li dropping low and low. It doesn't have the touch of karma at the same time. Looney dropping low. The Fist of Fury with a Lex into a triple DR cap stun. He needs to be careful. He gets that bark skin and bear form off at the same time. Cubsy dropping lower and lower as well. This dampening gaining in effect here.
Yeah, Looney's going to be tossing out some heals. The Wild Growth, very inefficient with their mana, but still big healing coming out from him, and he can afford it with that drink a little bit earlier on. Water's going to be gating away. Chun-Li chasing with the Flying Serpent Kick. Looney in good position to get the Cyclone up, but a nice Wind Shear from Cubsy to sport. 25% dampening right now. Chun-Li looking for Looney. He has no bar skin. He is playing the Relentless, keep in mind, but Chun-Li, he doesn't want to mess around. He wants to come back, help out his teammate. Big stun on Blizzo. Chanimals gates away before Blizzo can find any sort of pressure, and Cubsy's actually managed to top off his entire team without that Ascendant.
Indeed, he's doing such a good job on mana, so even though Looney's found some of those drinks, they're really equal of mana. This game can go either way, and Dampening keeps ticking and ticking. And I expect this game not to maybe enter in a snap onto Looney right now. Chun-Li just connecting with the Warwick. He teleports away. Chun-Li gonna try and get those swaps onto Looney. He actually fists him right now. The Fist of Fury come up onto him. A lot of pressure. He does bear from those. No legs be ready. And he holds onto those defense. Of course, there's a bash on the Chanimals right now. Blizzard unable to connect though. Chun-Li once again using that Ride the Wind. Getting away. Touch of Death now onto Warwick. Maybe they'll force a cooldown here. The Ironbark artifact comes out from Looney. He needs to make sure this Touch of Death doesn't take him down right now. He's going to be able to stabilize with that healing though.
Yeah, Chun-Li actually doing something we don't normally see Windwalker do. He's putting his images onto Looney while sitting on Warwick. So he's getting the Rising Sun Kick debuff on multiple targets. So it's very difficult for Looney to get that healing out. Fist of Fury stun onto Looney now. And as Dampening gets higher and higher, that Frenzied Regen, which is so powerful, the Resto Druid is going to become less and less effective, not allowing Looney to top himself off quite as easily.
Indeed. And this game is already at 32% Dampening, so Blizzard getting lower and lower. The Overture Tome coming up. They make a swap onto Blizzard right now as well. He's pretty low. No Ironbark again as well. Looney struggling to heal right now. Like you said, Looney is just not being able to deal with the split pressure from Chun-Li and Chanimals right now. They're able to kite away. Chanimals has great distance right now. A sap onto Looney right now. Can they follow up with anything else? No, they don't right now. It looks like Chun-Li is just going to tunnel down Warwick's, maybe try and force his wall and try and get a kill with the openings they have. Fist of Fury. He's dropping incredibly low right now. The Ironbark has to come out due to that pressure from Chun-Li, and he's going to have that Storm, Earth, and Fire very soon.
Yeah, very intelligent. Doesn't want to get Cyclone there, so he puts his port behind the pillar so he can avoid it if at all possible. Interrupt on the Looney into an Incapacitate. Chun-Li looked for the setup, but unfortunately, the Incapacitate broke. He wasn't able to get the stun. But in the meantime, Blizzo's rotting down low. Chun-Li uses his Touch of Karma offensively as well on the Looney, looking for damage, looking to close out this game at 38% Dampening. Chanimal soloing down Blizzo. Chun-Li comes back with a leg sweep. Blizzo's going to be able to survive. Looney's going to have to play catch up, though. This is so dire for both teams.
Indeed, Blizzard using that Battle Cry Bladestorm to connect and try and get some pressure now. He knows Chun-Li doesn't have the Touch of Karma, so there could be an opening for him, but it will be very difficult to get him. In fact, Blizzard is the one dropping lower and lower. Warwick gets Spelllock right now. The Dying by the Sword has to come out, but in the same time, that was on the back end of Looney. Drinker get it, but he gets in the full fit. This drink could win them or lose them the game, depending if Looney can out-heal this pressure. Warwick has to be using that wall, and the trinket comes out as well. They are just about surviving. The Touch of Death comes out. The wall comes out from Chanimals. 41% Dampening. I don't know who's going to win, Vindraki.
Yeah, Chun-Li realizing he's in trouble. Ports behind the pillar in execute range. Cubsy popping Netizen. He saved it for a rainy day, and this is the rainy day indeed. Able to get out very effective healing at this point in Dampening, topping off basically his entire team. Chun-Li needs to be careful, though. Doesn't have Touch of Karma for a little bit longer, but he doesn't care. Getting aggressive onto Walrix. Leg sweep comes out. Looney has the Ironbark. That should be enough to keep Walrix alive if he ports away. If they have any crowd control onto Looney, Walrix is going to be an incredibly vulnerable target from this point forward. No unending resolve, no Ironbark. Chun-Li's chasing him down. Oh. Interrupts the UAs. Does he have...
And Chun-Li needs to just be switching back and forth between the Warlock, between the Warrior, and then force Looney to consistently stay out of that bear form. And then when he can...
able to extend this to a Game 5 to keep North America's hopes alive at having an even BlizzCon, or will XRB to the moon be able to close it out here on Ruins of Lordaeron, a final fitting resting place? It's a cemetery, so it makes sense for it to end here.
Indeed, Crow is super teased on that, and will Blizzard be able to finally finish them in that gravestone there? Blizzard connects onto Chanimals right now. Ride the Wind coming out once again. He's going to use that Bladestorm with the Battlecry to try and connect, but I don't think he's even getting a take of damage onto Chanimals right now. The Vortex is going to help him to connect now. Right now, Chanimals might be looking to teleport. He does teleport into that room. Blizzard leaps for him. I'm sure the Gateway will come out right now to kite and get away from Blizzard. He might look to try and fear it, but that Leg Sweep denies the fear on the Gateway, which Blizzard has been so good to produce.
Yeah, decent pressure coming in from Super Frogs, but so far Looney's been able to heal through it quite easily. They haven't gone for any sort of crowd control chain just yet. Looney's been able to free cast. Chun-Li seems to just want to put out as much damage as he can onto Walrex, while really just crippling Blizzo with these hamstrings over and over and over, really delaying that mobility and the uptime that he has. Nice little swap going on Looney, but he gets into bear form. Very nicely done by Looney.
Indeed, that was such a great read. He pre-Ironbug voice and bear form. He just saved both of them in that go, so That was a great read from him. That was the touch of death committed by Chun-Li as well. Another ride the wind, a huge ride the wind for Channels to use to try and connect and Kai Blizzard. Blizzard uses that reflect on the Unstable Affliction. I believe he gets fake though from Channels. Another huge gateway. He gets charged right now as well. Blizzard is connected, chunking down his HP right now. Cubsy needs to save him. He goes into that battle stance. He used the sharpened blade as well. Pummels Channels getting lower and lower. No cooldowns being used. The stun gets pre-bared once again by Looney. He is on fire with these bear forms.
Yeah, Looney's been doing an incredible job in this matchup. Double Fist of Fury Stun coming in from Chun-Li. Big burst on Walrex and Blizzo. Is this their moment they decide to go all in? No Iron Bar is going to be available. Cubsy playing a little bit passive. Does get interrupted on the heal. He's at full mana, but his entire team is dying. He needs to play catch up very, very quickly. Chun-Li rotting down. He really can't get too aggressive. Doesn't want to get into that XE range. Going for the cheeky, crackling Jade Lightning once again, but Blizzo does not fall for it.
Indeed, it's so great to see Chun-Li utilizing that and trying knocking him as well. The battle cry Blazeman comes out once again from Blizzard, trying to chunk down Channels. The Healing Tide and the Urbitual Tome come out now to deal with this flat, with this pressure. Another Spellock coming out from Warlix right now. So much pressure mounting. Chun-Li has to peel Blizzard. He puts him into that Fist of Fury stun right now. Ride the wind for Channels as well. Gonna allow him to Kai Blizzard even on these small maps.
Yeah, Cubsy looking for the heals, able to find it on the Channels as well as himself. Chun-Li should be in a very safe position with Trinket, with Karma. But everyone from Super Frogs is still rotting down. Most of the damage is coming from XRB to the moon. Looney hasn't been in any significant CC change this matchup yet. There's been a few attempts to swap to him, but he's doing a good job. Fist of Fury stunned out onto Blizzo with an interrupt on Looney. Can they take him down? Can they force out the dive by the sword? Looks like Blizzo's going to play a greedy. Looney not even going to throw out the Iron Bark, but he's into the fear. This is still very dangerous. Touch of Death actually gets committed by Chun-Li onto Warwick, trying to create split pressure for his team.
Indeed, they're making this incredibly difficult for Looney to heal, and Chun-Li has been able to find Chinks in Blizzard's armor, catching him out of form, and catching Looney out of form right now as well. Gonna be very difficult for him to heal. He's gonna have that artifact very soon. May need to use that to top off his entire team. Blizzard getting on the offensive as well, chunking down Channels. But like you said, Cubsy's just somehow doing an excellent job with his mana pool right now, but he's getting caught out. Blizzard pummels him, goes into that battle stance, he forces out the Astral Shift, the bash onto him as well as the spell lock. He's getting lower and lower. He decides to trinket it. He needs to top himself at the same time. Leg sweep onto Looney and the Blizzard. Chun-Li trying to get a lot of pressure onto them, but is unable to connect with Channels since he's kiting.
Yep, nicely done by XRB to the moon. That was a nice attempt on Cubsy. He had to use his trinket and the Astral Shift, like you said, so that was very nicely done, but Super Frogs honestly doing a great job, even when they're forced into these defensive positions, still finding these opportunities with the double stuns to get damage out and stay in the game. Channels needs to get away from Blizzo. Blizzo running over to him, trying to find the damage. In the meantime, Walrus getting caught into a Fist of Fury Stun, a little bit of damage coming in from him, but Chun-Li doing the same thing. Look at his images on Looney, putting up the Rising Sun Kick debuff, just rotting down the enemy team, and this is something we don't normally see from a Windwalker monk.
Indeed, and it worked out in Tolviron, so will it work out now? This split pressure coming in from Chun-Li. A full cycle actually lands on the Cubsy. The Touch of Karma comes out instantly onto Blizzo, but they are reversing that pressure because of that. They actually go through the Touch of Karma. Chun-Li's going to be in a lot of trouble. He needs to be careful. He still has his trinket and the Fortify Brew and has done an excellent job. And this Blizzo just still pounding onto Channels right now, doing so much damage in that battle stance. Sharpen Blade comes out as well. They need to be careful. Ride the Wind comes out. A teleport as well. Chun-Li going aggressive onto Looney. The Infernal Stun. Leg Sweep as well. They're bursting him down, but they don't even force a Barkskin. Even with this go, they're able to hold on to it, and XRB to the moon looking defensively superb.
Yeah, Chun-Li still on Looney, though. Looney could be in some trouble. He uses the dash to get away, but Chun-Li's still all over him. Looney should be okay. He manages to displace to safety. Chun-Li, he decided to chase. He wants to take Looney down. He wants Fox Pressure Paralysis now onto Looney low. A little bit of damage coming from Blizzo onto Channels as Cubsy does get interrupted. Once again, Super Frog's looking to spread that damage. Interrupt onto Cubsy though. Channels might be forced to Hellstone. He ports away to safety. Can Blizzo reconnect?
Indeed, he's just trying his best. The Vortex might help that. A full bash onto Channels as well. He's trying to get away from that. He does indeed. I don't think the Vortex actually landed on him. So a little mistake coming in from Looney, but a Spelllock once again onto Cubsy. Warwick is on top of the Spelllocks. Blizzo though also just dropping lower and lower. He does that have that charge execute though, kills off that pet, but Channel survives it, but he's gonna get those victory rushes as well, which can help him stabilize. The double Fist of Fury coming out from Chun-Li right now. He's trying to pressure them both, like you said. Splitting pressure, Ben Rookie could be that key to win.
Yeah, Cubsy's actually ahead on mana, which is kind of unbelievable to me in this situation with the rest of Druid versus the rest of Shaman. Looney caught into the incapacitate. Walrus going to be porting away. Chun-Li turning his attention once again onto Blizzo, trying to peel for channels. Unfortunately, there's a triple DR leg sweep onto Blizzo, so really not getting too much value there, but he will be able to ride the wind in order to support channels just a bit. But Blizzo still all over and pops the battle stance, looking to get aggressive.
Indeed, pops the battle cry now as well, looking to get very, very aggressive onto channels, but Cubsy is just free casting those heals right now. Chun-Li also keeps swapping between Blizzo and Warwick, forcing Blizzo to go into battle stance sometimes. He's trying to get that crackling Jade Lightning knock once again, but Blizzard's not falling for that bait. He's on top of Chanimals right now. Looney using his bashes onto Chanimals over and over again, forcing out those trinkets and those human racials.
Yep, Chanimals and Chun-Li rotting down very low. The stand is still going to be available for Cubsy. Walrus taking a little bit of damage right now, but Looney's been doing such a good job in this game, making it difficult for Chun-Li to get those swaps when he needs to. Anytime he does, he's always in bear form as well. Whoa. Double leg sweep coming in from Chun-Li. Can they find the damage on Blizzo and Walrus? Doesn't look like it. Chun-Li not able to really do too much damage, and that's one of the disadvantages of the Windwalker monk. The consistent damage just isn't there in games like this.
Indeed, and they're both playing Orc Relentless, so the stuns last a very short time. So they need to make the swaps onto Looney, and they find him, they snap him out from, they use that Fist of Fury, but he's not going to have the leg sweep to follow up right now. Chun-Li having to use that Fortify Brew as well to just survive the dot pressure coming in from Warwick. And like I said, Cubsy's doing an excellent job with Nana, but now Looney has drank in a high manner, and it is 15% dampening. Chun-Li getting lower and lower as well as Chanimals, and now because of that drink, once again, it's looking bleak for Super Frogs.
Yeah, Super Frogs tournament life on the line. Cubsy gets interrupted. Chanimals still low. Blizzo reconnects. Cubsy going to be able to get a little bit of healing right now. Chanimals still has the gateway available.
Oh!
But another spell lock coming in from Walrus, doing an insane job this game. Chanimals gets lower and lower. Unending Resolve is going to be used. Healthstone is going to be used as well as the Ascendant. So Super Frogs having to use every single defensive in that situation. But a nice swap over onto Looney. He's going to be able to respond, though. He has the Iron Bark. He has the Bark Skin. Displaces away. Chun-Li is going to be chasing. Can Chun-Li solo down this healer? Looney needs to respond appropriately using the Iron Bark. I think he's going to be okay in this situation. Incapacitate going to be thrown out as he looks to put some pressure onto Blizzo.
Indeed. Every time Chun-Li goes offensive onto Looney, they're looking dangerous. But at the same time, so is Chanimals. He's so low. He needs to make that decision whether he tries to kill Looney or he has to peel Blizzo. And it's such a difficult situation right now. And this Kaien is saving him from now. Looney's dropping low, though, due to that Dispel right now. Touch of Death committed onto Warwick. He's using that wall right now. That's a huge cooldown they've got. He's going to summon that Feral Hunter, but actually it gets Paralysis and then a Fist of Fury. Chun-Li doing an excellent job denying that pet summon from Warwick. It's going to make it even harder for XRB to the moon to close out this game.
Warwick gets his pet out though. Chun-Li ran out of interrupts though. He didn't want to mess around with him too much longer. 22% dampening. Super Frogs doing everything they can to stay alive in this tournament. Cubsy doing okay on mana. Looney getting a little bit lower, but still doing quite well. Warwick's at around 50%. HP as Chun-Li charges in, gets the stun on Looney. Can he take him down? LOSing the fear. Nice positioning coming in from Chun-Li. This matchup now an incapacitate onto Looney. Chun-Li looking to reconnect. In the meantime, Blizzo really tearing in two channels. But Chun-Li there once again to support. Chun-Li just MVP in this matchup.
Indeed, he is so MVP. He's absolutely absurd on that Windwalker monk. And he's getting the stuns onto Warwick now, pressuring him right now. Warwick doesn't have that wall for a while, so they could look for a kill opportunity onto him. Looney does have that iron
scary
though as well. He is very low and HP. The same with Blizzard. They're actually all somehow rotting down right now. Looney needs to play catch up right now with his healing. Blizzo's really far pushed in though. He needs to be careful as well. He gets Fist of Fury. He's very low on HP. Looney trying to cast out the heals. He connects that regrowth, but he actually line of sights that healing touch. That could be the end of Blizzo's life. Actually, Ironbark and the artifact coming out. And that line of sight opportunities is these small differences that could cost them the game.
Yeah, War still doesn't have unending resolve for quite some time. Super Frog still has a chance here. Interrupt onto Cubsy. Chun-Li a little bit low, but he has a touch of karma as a safety net. 30% dampening. Super Fox has good positioning, good kiting on this map. XRB still in it though. Looney trying to restabilize his team's HP, but Walrus getting bursted down. Interrupt on Looney. That's the Hellstone coming in from Walrus. The last line of defense for XRB. Super Frogs might be able to close out this game and tie up the series.
Indeed, and once again, Blizzard trying to leap and connect onto Chanimals. He's kiting away for now. Reconnects with that charge. Spell lock onto Walrus right now. He doesn't want to give them any momentum because right now, Super Frogs has that momentum. They don't want to lose it. Chun-Li doing a lot of damage onto Walrus. They don't have the Iron Bug. They don't have the wall as well. And they still have the Rallying Cry. He's somehow able to heal this, dispels the Unstable Afflictions. Warwick now gets out that Fell Hunter, but like you said, Chun-Li still has that Touch of Karma. Chanimals still has that wall as well, and they're just looking very good now into dampening.
Yeah, this is looking very solid. Cubsy gets interrupted. Chun-Li has the Touch of Karma. He's going to be moving forward. He ports away in Execute range. This is dangerous! He actually survives the Execute. That was a little bit lucky there for the Super Frogs. Blizzo tried to close out the game, but Chun-Li able to get that Touch of Karma off during that Execute. execute. Blizzo tossing out the die by the sword as well. This is scary for XRB. They really don't have too many defenses left to work with. The Iron Rock going to be used by Looney as well. That was so scary for Super Frogs. Fist of Fury now on Blizzo. He gets slower. Walrus rotting down a little bit in the meantime. Cubsy almost completely tapped on mana.
Indeed, Looney had to use the Iron Rock as well, the die by the sword, and that all came just because they Trundy pretty much lucked out of living there right now. The Touch of Karma did a lot of damage onto Blizzo as well as that Touch of Death spell locks onto Cubsy. Once again, Warwick Chanimals doing an excellent job here with these spell locks. Chanimals dropping low as well. He has that wall if needed, but at this stage of 40% dampening, I'm not sure if it's going to do much. They catch out Looney once again. Chunny doing excellently. The Infernal Stuns comes out as well. Beautiful Fizz. Chanimals very low. He might just go down right now. The Spirit Link just about in the nick of time. Once again, Blizzo is denied to finish them both. The spell lock onto Cubsy though right now. The Astral Shift comes out. They're all very low from that Spirit Link. Chun-Li has to peel Blizzo. He might be able to kill him as well. The Iron Bark comes out, but the Fool Seduce, it gets interrupted right now. Looney does have the Iron Bark, and this is looking dire for Super Frogs right now.
Chun-Li trying to keep the snares up onto Blizzo and just kite. All three members flailing for their life right now for Super Frogs. Tournament life on the line. Channel ports away, trying to do one last step on the water, but Blizzo closes out the game. Closes out the series and sends Super Frogs packing.
Man, honestly, if you were an NA fan there, I think you started to feel the hope. It almost looked like it would be possible. Like you would see the reverse sweep. Chun-Li, an absolute god throughout that game, throughout that series. The Super Frogs, a very impressive squad to represent the NA. The NA truly lucky to be represented by such an incredible team. But XRB is back. They have already proved it in this tournament. They were one of the most dominant teams in the world at the beginning of the year, and now they are going to be going to the grand final. And the question is, will they be able to figure something out against Method Black? Because as much as XRB looked like one of the most dominant teams when we started off the year, Method Black has proven to be one of the most dominant teams, and they're waiting for him in the grand final, Seiko.
I mean, it's got to feel good to make it to the final, but yeah, it's got to be on their minds now in XRB. They got to figure out a way to beat the Elemental Outlaw, the kryptonite of them this entire season. 18-5 record between those two teams, and I mean, I'm skeptical, but if they play the Windwalker Lock Shaman throughout the entire finals, they definitely have a shot, because it didn't look too bad in their previous series. And speaking of that, I really think if Super Frogs played the Windwalker Lock Shaman from the first game here, we could have potentially had a completely different final. What a game to end it on. They definitely
to see that, and we're going to get to see some of that high level play right now. And as you can see on your screen, 43% dampening. It really did go the distance. And when XRB can dampen, when they don't let up, when they...
Rich, I'm down on the side with the man, the myth, the legend, Blizzo. He said that no one has ever been dampened that hard before. What an amazing final. How did it feel going through that game?
I feel really good. We played really good. I actually played really insane on the run game. I feel like gate three times. And I felt like already before the series started, we're going to win because we are the better team.
Just the better team. You heard it here first. Obviously, this is a new roster for you. You were playing with Triforce last year. Now you're playing with this new roster. Do you feel more confident in this team?
Well, yes. I think we'll do like really good if we make it to BlizzCon. And I don't know. I actually really enjoy to play with them. So that's why I chose to play with them this year.
Really happy to play with them. And then obviously, Method Black has been a difficult team for you guys to beat. Seems to always be the pesky pirate that takes you out. Do you have any surprises for Method Black moving into the rematch in the grand finals?
We just need to play good and pray to the gods that he's not going to get coin every single roll, because like, the spec is broken.
All right. Waz's Pirate Rogue might be the finishing move here if you can get a little bit lucky, but back to you, Rich.
Team that XRB has lost to is Method Black, and now they actually have a chance to get that rematch, to get their revenge. And if they do it in the grand final, they win the entire tournament, they win $50,000, and they get a spot to BlizzCon. So I think it would feel that much